Here I'm going to briefly describe how we would do linear regression for kinetic data. And the idea is we want to determine the kinetic parameters, where we're given rate of reaction for two reactants. So the reaction is A plus B goes to C plus D. And we want to fit this with a rate expression. So minus R sub A, and we could call that R, make it positive. Rate constant, concentration of A to some power, concentration of B to some power. And so what we're going to use linear regression for is determine K, N, and M. And the way we're going to do it is to take the log of this equation. So we have the log of rate is the log of K plus N times the log concentration of A plus M times the log of the concentration of B. And so this is a form of Y equals A0 plus parameter A1 times variable X1 plus A2 X2. I've written in this form because this is the format that's used in polymath. I'm going to use polymath to get the parameters. I'm not going to show you here how to use the polymath program, but in other screencasts, we'll show the polymath program for this particular example. Of course, the idea of linear regression, this would be called multiple linear regression, is sum of squares, the difference between the log of the rate experimental, that's what's in the table here, minus the log of the rate calculated from our model for the best fit parameters squared, and that's what we're trying to minimize. So this is referred to as a sum of the residuals squared. So if we use polymath to minimize this summation, we're going to get parameters out for the values along the confidence limits. So let's look at the results. So here we're given the values for A0, A1, and A2, approximately first order in concentration of A and half order in the concentration of B. A0, remember, is the log of K, and so we can calculate K. We can calculate confidence limits. They're not going to be the same above and below because of when we put these values in for the log, then the exponential, these values are going to differ. And let's not worry about the details of that. It varies between 0.033 for the higher end and 0.064 for the lower end. But the confidence intervals are a small fraction of the values, which is what we desire for a good fit. What we want to do is we can compare this to nonlinear regression for the same data. So let me show you that result. So here, the nonlinear regression, the R squared value is actually slightly smaller. The values for K, very close. Likewise for N and M. The 95% confidence interval, actually larger for the nonlinear regression than for the linear regression. However, generally, you have to be careful with linear regression. So here, I'll give you a reference for more details, but this reference in Journal of Chemical Education points out that linear least squares, like we've done here, may not be a good method for evaluating a rate constant for first order reaction or second order. This is looking at plotting concentration versus time on a log scale for first order and expecting a straight line. And they point out that concentration has a constant error, but the log of the concentration does not, and so therefore these values aren't equally reliable. And part of the assumption of the least squares is that we're weighting all of the values equally at low concentrations and at high concentrations. But in either case, you can see we can use linear and nonlinear regression to develop parameters for a kinetic model for kinetic data.